So we were discussing about the chapter work energy. So first we discussed about work, calculation of the work and different type of work, positive work, negative work, all those things we discussed. After that we discussed about energy, what is kinetic energy, then equation for kinetic energy, unit for work, unit for energy. After that we discussed about the potential energy, what is potential energy, for which objects potential energy will be there. After that, conservation of mechanical energy, that is kinetic energy plus potential energy makes mechanical energy. So mechanical energy, kinetic energy can be converted into potential energy, and potential energy can be converted into kinetic energy. And when an object is dropped from a height, what happens to the kinetic energy, what happens to the potential energy, all those things we discussed. So almost the part of work and energy we discussed. But now we have to think about a new thing, which is called as power. So just like energy, we are using another word, power. Something is very much powerful. An engine is very much powerful. A vehicle is more powerful. Or even a person is more powerful. So what is the meaning of this power? Rate of doing work, that is called as power. Rate of doing work means in a particular time, we will take in 1 second. 1 second, how much work can be done? That is called as power. So if more powerful, it can do more work in a short time. That is called as more power. For example, you have a particular amount of substance here. One person can take it and keep to another place by taking 1 hour. And another person can do the same work, but the person takes 2 hours. So the first person is more powerful because he is finishing the work very fast. So here we have a relation between this work and the time also. So we can write the power as, or the definition of power as, rate of doing work, that is called as power. So when you write it as an equation, the power is given by, power is equal to work by time. Or we can write P is equal to W by T, work done by time. So the work done by time, that is called as power. So something is more powerful means in a short time it can do more work. So how we calculated the work done for a boy climbing a step, he is climbing a step of 10 meter, what will be the work done like that. Now if you get the time also, if you divide with the time, you can calculate the power also. Okay, so this power is generally measured in joules per second, because its work is in joules and its time is in second. So it will come as joules per second. So the unit is joules per second, but for this joules per second we have a single unit, that is called as watts. Okay, so 1 watt means it is 1 joule per second. We will write it as W. Okay, so 10 watts means we will write 10 W. So SI unit of power is watts. 1 watt can be written as 1 joule per second also. And whenever we are calculating this power, always we may not be writing in watts, because 1 watt is a small power. Sometimes we will use some other unit also. So another type of unit which we are using is kilowatt. So 1 kilowatt, when you are writing kilowatt, small k and capital W. 1 kilowatt means it is 1000 watt. Okay, and another power unit also is there, which commonly people use, which is HP. HP means horsepower. So for machines and all, we will tell HP. So this 1 HP is actually 746 watts. Okay, so 1 HP is actually less than 1 kilowatt. Okay, 746 watts is called as HP. In your calculation and all, this horsepower will not come. We will calculate everything in joules and watts and kilowatts, that one only. It's a old type of unit. Still, if somewhere if you see, you should know what it is. That's why I explained. So I think it is clear. So power means it is rate of doing work. So power is more means within a short time it can do more work. That's called as high power, more power. And this power is written as work done by time. So it is W by T. And the unit will be joules per second, which is again called as watts. And again we can use this kilowatt also. 1 kilowatt means it is 1000 joules. Again another one I told, it is horsepower HP, which is 746 watts. Okay, 746 watts is called as 1 HP. or one horsepower. And I already mentioned it is it will not come for your examination and not for your, because we are doing everything in SI unit. Now this is about power, but when we are purchasing the power or energy from the market, market means we are not just going and purchasing the energy from the normal market. It is purchasing energy from the market means we are purchasing electricity such way, that is electricity you are purchasing from the electricity board or whoever is supplying electricity to us, the government or the company who is purchasing from them, we are purchasing, okay, the energy. So energy can be purchased as electrical energy. So when you purchase this energy, we have to pay them. So how much energy we are purchasing for that one, some unit is required. So that is called as the commercial unit of energy. That is when your business we are doing, that's called as commerce. So the commercial unit of energy is not this one. Generally the unit is joules. So one joule is very small. So that's why we will use another unit. So the concept is like this. If you are using 1 kilowatt energy for 1 hour, if you are using 1 kilowatt energy for 1 hour, that is considered as one unit. So one unit means 1 kilowatt we are using for 1 hour. That is called as our one unit. So electricity, there you may have seen your electricity meter, it is showing 100 units and all. They will simply use the word unit. So one unit means it is 1 kilowatt we are using for 1 hour. So that's why we will call it as kilowatt hour, KWH. This kilowatt hour. So 1 kilowatt hour will be how much joules? That also we can find out. I think you understood the meaning of 1 kilowatt hour. That is per second 1000 watts. That's called as 1000 joules. That is called as 1 kilowatt. Like that we are using for 1 hour. So already we know the power is given by, power is work done by time, or power is energy by time. So this energy or work done can be written as power into time. That's important. Energy or work done, work done and energy is same. Okay, work done or energy is written as power into time. So here you see kilowatt is power into h hour, that is time. So we can write this one as kilowatt hour. So how much will be 1 kilowatt hour? We can calculate that one. So 1 kilowatt hour. So how much will be 1 kilowatt? Means it is 1000 watts, 100,000. Okay, 1000 watts into 1 hour. 1 hour will be how much seconds? 1 hour. 1 hour contains 60 minutes, and each minute contains 60 seconds. So 60 into 60. So it will be 3600 seconds. So this will be, if you multiply this one, 3, 6, then 5 zeros. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This much joules, because watts into second is joules. Okay. So we can write 1 kilowatt hour as this much joules, or we can write in scientific notation. Scientific notation means this can be written as 3.6 into 10 to the power 6 joules. So 1 kilowatt hour is equal to this much. So this is what we will call as one unit. So one unit of electricity is used, means how much is used? 3.6 into 10 to the power 6 joules of energy is used. Okay, so this is the last thing which we have to study in our this chapter. So in our work energy chapter, we have to do numericals, calculations and all those things are pending. We just discussed about the theory only. So once more in the theory, we started from where? We started from work, equation for work, that is F dot S or F into S you taken, and afterwards we discussed when positive work, when negative work, when work is not done, that is perpendicular thing, all those things you have to recapitulate, all those things. Okay, after that energy, kinetic energy, potential energy, conversion, all those things in the beginning of this one I told. So again I am not repeating. And we have the power also. So all the calculations also based on this one. First you do the textbook, solve the questions, then unsolved questions, then you can refer some other books also, and if you have any doubt you can ask also. Okay, so we will wind up the theory part of this one, and now we will come up with the problems, numerical problems on this chapter. Okay, so I think the theory part is over here. So we will see while doing the